20,000 fans jam Chicago Stadium to see this final game of perhaps the most exciting and dramatic Stanley Cup playoffs in NHL history. Because of the excitement, the CBS television network preempted its prime time regular programming to carry this game. That, coupled with the two Canadian television networks, enabled more than 25 million viewers to see hockey at its best. The game opens with a great offensive move by Hull, but somehow Dryden manages to keep the puck out. Esposito comes out to cut down the angle on Frank Mahovlich. It was one big save after another. During this first period, both goalies made saves that were nothing short of miraculous. Now in the final minutes of the first period, watch as Dennis Hull, number 10, beats Dryden from an unlikely angle to give Chicago a 1-0 lead. Big question in this game was, would home ice continue to be a deciding factor? Both teams have won every game on their home ice so far. Martin centers the puck to O'Shea. He knocks it down, gets control, and fires it home. And it's 2-0 for the Blackhawks at 7:33 of the second period. Only the crossbar saved Dryden on that blast by Bobby Hull. Chicago seemed to be completely in control until Lemaire surprised everybody, including Esposito, with a bullet-like shot from just over center ice, and the complexion of the game started to change. That unexpected goal makes it 2-1, with slightly over 5 minutes left to play in the second period. Pappen at the side of the net misses an excellent chance to put Chicago further ahead. But a minute and 40 seconds before the second period ended, Richard had tied the score 2-2. Now it's down to the final 20 minutes of this tense drama, and the tension mounts. Poole fights for the puck. Feeds it to Ferguson, but Esposito makes the stop. Canadians are carrying the attack. That's Henry Richard going in on left wing. He manages to elude Magnuson's diving check and shoots the puck over the falling Esposito. Montreal goes ahead 3-2. Now the pressure is on Chicago. They have to attack, and this save on Pappen is typical of the way Dryden is frustrating the Blackhawks. Chicago's best chance to tie the score came when Pappen again was stopped by Dryden, this time with a fantastic leg save. Time is running out, and Esposito is trying to get to the bench for a sixth attacker, but Hull and Ferguson force Tony to stay in his goal. Less than a minute remaining, Esposito races to the bench, and Chicago sends six men into the Canadian zone. Pete Mahovlich clears the puck down ice. Only seconds remain. Here comes Makita. Over to Martin. He loses control, and the puck comes out of the Montreal end. And the game is over. The Montreal Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup for a record 16th time. These great Chicago fans stand to cheer the champions and their valiant Blackhawks. As the players exchange congratulatory handshakes, the tension and fatigue shows in the face of Henry Richard, who tonight let his actions speak louder than his words. NHL President Clarence Campbell presents the Stanley Cup to Captain Jean Béliveau, his 10th Stanley Cup, a record he shares with Richard. In the dressing room, the Canadians were exhausted but happy. They'd given their all on the ice. Nobody could blame them for being weary. And Béliveau tugged off his sweater for the final time. Soon after this victory parade, the 39-year-old Béliveau, one of the greatest names in the NHL, announced his retirement. But Montreal fans had a new young hero in their midst, 23-year-old rookie goaltending sensation, Ken Dryden, the playoffs' most valuable player. Coach McNeil rode with Canadiens president David Molson and the 500,000 proud citizens of Montreal who turned out to pay tribute to their beloved Canadiens, so jammed the streets that it took 2.5 hours to go only 2 miles. But who cares? The Cup was back in Montreal.